The other, I had some questions on the road, on the length of the road, the right-of-way, the paved area, and what the slopes are proposed to be on the finished road, the grade and slope.
The planning board has all the information. They have a complete packet of all the information you are asking. Right now, off the top of my head, I have to look back at our packet to exactly to tell you what we have for slopes. But it all is within the zoning ordinance of Cape Elizabeth. We have prepared a complete, a very, very complete, extensive package for the planning board.
I guess that's my major concern. I mean, we're being asked to accept the road, and if you look at it, it's got a lot of...
We're not being asked to accept the road. Are we not being asked to do that?
Yeah, it's conditional acceptance.
Yeah.
But eventually, I mean, this kind of gives the go-ahead to the planning board, and then it comes back here for final acceptance as built.
That's right. Madam Chairman, pro temp, the, you know, this road was already approved back, actually, by the planning board twice. It was once in the 60s and once in the early 70s. What's actually being proposed here is a discontinuation of part of the approved road. The road was already agreed to be accepted by the town way, way back then, and instead, Mr. Fitzpatrick is discontinuing a portion of it that would have connected up to Hemlock Hill, and he's also providing the turnaround that's been required by the fire department.
So was this considered then a paper road?
It's a...
Isn't this another process to get rid of a paper road?
It's an approved subdivision road already, yes.
Is this the proper process to get rid of a paper road? Would you do it at the public hearing?
All where the council's being asked to do this evening is to agree to accept the lot and to agree to accept the road as shown on the plan. We haven't addressed the issue of whether or not there needs to be an abandonment of the section in the middle, but my sense is that's being accomplished by the amended subdivision plan by the planning board. That will have the de facto result of eliminating.
Okay. Councilor McGinty.
I'm curious if we're being maybe premature in this, if we should wait for this to go through the planning board process first to see what the final plan is. I mean, certainly Ms. Fitzpatrick probably doesn't want to change, but it may be modified in some way that we're not aware of.
This is the normal procedure all the time, is that before Mr. Fitzpatrick gets final approval of his amended subdivision plan, it's required to first come to the town council to agree to accept the public improvements. This is the routine process. And at some point, maybe we ought to revisit it, because that question comes up from time to time. But, you know, the planning board never feels they ought to give final approval until they know all the pieces are in place, which is if anything's being offered to anyone, i.e. the council, that the council's agreeing to accept it. It is a catch-22, though, but this is the normal procedure.
I certainly feel comfortable. The manager's not going to let it come before us unless it's not the proper procedure tonight. Go ahead, Carol.
But now, in the approval before, it was maybe, I mean, they didn't really deal with the engineered design of the road.
Yes, they...
Did it go all the way through?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was according to the subdivision standards that were in place back in the 60s and when it was redone in the 70s. You know, Mr. Fitzpatrick, if he chose to, could go in and build that today. Maybe it's not economically feasible. Maybe, you know, it's not the type of lots that people want to buy at this point. But he has the right under the law to do that earlier subdivision. And that's, you know, one reason is, you know, even though there's a lot of neighborhood opposition, the town's being very careful in with this subdivision. But, you know, the town staff to be sure that it's clearly understood that Mr. Fitzpatrick or any owner of this subdivision does have the inherent right to develop it as it was originally approved. And that's what we have letters from the town attorney that indicate that.
But I'm wondering, at the time, at the ordinances at the time, did the town council still have the option to accept or not after it was built?
I have not researched to see if the council specifically voted in 1971 or two, the last time this came before. I just don't know. Yeah, but I presume that, you know, that was the way it was always done back then. But, you know, that was the first couple of years. It used to be the town meeting did it. And it was 67, they ended the town meeting, and I'm not too... too sure. But I know in the 20, almost 21 years I've been here, this is the procedure that's been used every time, is either a lot offered or a road offered. It's come to the council before final planning board approval.
My only concern is that just looking at the slopes on the parcel, it looks like it could be a problem road if it's not designed properly. And the point of our looking at the roads ahead of time and accepting them is so that we won't have a maintenance problem down the line sometime. We're supposed to accept the well-designed road. So I don't know if there's just a way to convey to the planning board some concern about looking at that design. I mean, I don't know if you're planning on blasting it flat or what, but it's...
I could answer some of
the... Let's let him address this a little bit.
Yeah, we are going with the planning board, you know, pretty heavily right now with design, road design. We are building this road to today's town standards. Mm-hmm. If you had a chance to look at the plan that we have proposed to the planning board, we have already been found complete. As far as the planning board goes, our plan has been found complete, and we are building this road to town standards, today's town standards, with slopes, grades, drainage. We've done a very extensive drainage report on this subdivision. So I think if you looked at that package that we are presenting to the planning board, it would answer your questions. Mm-hmm.
So are you going to, like, raise the road up where it
we will be, the, yes.
Because you're supposed to have a road much level when it meets an intersection.
Exactly. There will be cuts and fills, and at the beginning of the road, you can't have, I think the town standard is no more than a 3% slope. We have a 2.8 for the beginning, and so we are meeting today's standards for road design.
I feel comfortable with that. I think those are, you who've sat on the planning board know those kind of questions.
Well, yeah,
the new planning board will ask those questions. Councilor Reed.
Yes, I'd like to make a motion that the town council consider, pursuant to the subdivision ordinance, section 16.2.4, paragraph C2D, I don't know how to do all those parens, so we are asking the town council to grant a conditional municipal approval to the proposal that has been presented to us for the dedication of a public road, public sewer, and a parcel of land to be used as open space, understanding that this is conditional upon the planning board's approval and satisfactory construction of the road.
Second.
Who seconded?
Second.
John. Thank you. It's been moved and seconded. Is there any more discussion? All those in favor? Opposed? 7-0.
Six.
One abstention.
No, it's not even abstention. It's a
abstain. Thank you. Two in a row?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
If it's any interest in anyone, when I grew up, there was the single house down there. Nothing. No roads, no houses.
Yeah, well, this town was a little different in the 1800s.
And it was definitely before you were born.
And I'm 50 this year.
Still before you were born.
And thank you very much for filling in his chair. Citizens' discussion of items not on the agenda. There is none.
One thing, Mr. Chairman, on the workshop, I think it's scheduled for the 15th of March, and a couple of councilors had a possible conflict. I wonder if that still holds on the 15th or what's going on.
It certainly appears that the workshop that's scheduled for the 15th, because a couple of councilors cannot attend, will have to be rescheduled. I think we can address that issue
in the workshop
when they have after the cameras are off. But anybody who cares about the date of that workshop, Mr. McGovern will have it, and you can call Town Hall, but it will not be Monday the 15th.
Thank you.
Councilor Reed.
Will we be notifying automatically the people who are the primary participants? Or
Mr. McGovern will notify the primary participants that it's not going to happen Monday, and we will, and he will notify them of the rescheduled date that we're going to set as soon as this meeting's over.
Okay, and the last thing I wanted to ask is, I didn't know if Representative Martin had anything to add, because he's neither exactly public nor exactly counsel. Okay, thank you.
All right. Is there a motion to enter executive session to continue the annual evaluation of the town manager?
I will make that motion, Mr. Chairman.
That's been moved and seconded to enter executive session to continue the annual evaluation of the town manager. All in favor? 7-0. It is not anticipated that we will be coming back into public session tonight. So thank you very much and good night.
Where's my
Joe?